Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel. For my other videos, kindly refer to the links given in the description below. In this video, I am going to explain how to typeset equations, whether unnumbered, numbered or aligned as the case may be. Let us take up the technique center editor and we have this sentence. Area of a circle of radius r is a equal to pi r square. We compile this and we get this as the output. Notice that for the equal to sign, I have not given any space in the editor. However, there will be a space on either side of the equal to sign because equal to sign is a binary operator. For superscripts, we use the caret symbol. The symbol that is available above number 6 in the keyboard. Press the shift and then type 6, you will get this caret symbol. For single character superscripts, there is no need to use curly braces here. You will get the output already. However, for superscripts with more than one character, curly brace is a must. But what I would suggest is, whether it is single character or more than one character, you always get into the practice of using curly braces for superscripts. Now, let us consider the output here. A equal to pi r square. If the radius is not r, it is r1. How to get the subscript? Use underscore and then again as before use curly braces where it is for single character or more than one character and then you will get the output. Alright. You will notice that both the subscript and superscript are aligned vertically in the output. It is not so in the case of MS Word. Those who are interested in having an output as available in MS Word, we may group accordingly like this. Pi, suppose you want to group the subscript first. In the second case, let us say you want to group the superscript. Then you can have it like this. Subscript first and then superscript in the first case and the reverse in the second case. Now, let us say we would like to have an unnumbered equation here. A equal to pi r square. I am not using a subscript, curly braces for the superscript because of I have the privilege of my age. Right. You have a equal to pi r square. Remember that there is no equation number, but this equation is centered on a line by itself. This is called, second one is called display equation. The first one is called inline equation. Now, suppose you would like to have equation number for this. Then you have to use the equation environment and this equation. You will have equation number 1 appearing on the extreme right of the text area automatically. The next equation will be numbered 2, 3, 4, etc. automatically. Now, let us say we want to have square root without the horizontal line at the top and then the square root as we normally do and then cube root means with the option option bracket, square bracket 3. You can have it like this. In the first case, there is no horizontal line on the top. Such constructs are used for single characters of the arguments. In the second case, you have square root as we normally write it. In the third case, you have the cube root. You can have nth root, etc. Anything is possible. Whatever you give within the option bracket, square brackets, will be appearing here. Okay. Then, let me take fractions. The command is slash frac followed by two pairs of curly braces. Within the first pair, you give the numerator. In the second pair, you give the denominator. On compilation, you will have fraction 1 by 2. Now, I give a mandatory, optional space. Otherwise, the characters will be jumbled one over the other. I have a fraction in which the denominator itself is a fraction, like this. Now, same thing can be used to typeset differentials dy by dx. Or if you want, you can have d square y by dx square, etc. All that you have to do is put here caret 2 and then similarly put here caret 2. You will have d square y by dx square. Or any order of differential can be typed like this. But let me confine myself to the first order, dy by dx. If you look at the output, you will have dy by dx. Unless you are very clear about what you are typing, you may misunderstand that the numerator is a product of two variables d and y, and the denominator is a product of d and y, so that you may be tempted to cancel d in the numerator and denominator. Therefore, what I would suggest is, you can have, for this d, use rmd, and for also this d, use rmd. This way, in the output you will find, d will appear to be in the Roman font, and y and x will appear in math font, indicating d is an operator and not a variable. Now, there are other ways of representing differentials. The simplest one is dot y. Actually, this is dy by dt, rate of y. For second order differential, you may have ddot. For third order, you can have 3ds. Then, yet another method of representing the same thing is bar y. Again, you may be tempted that if you use 2b's here or 3b's here, we may get second and third order versions. No, it is not so. To get the second order version, what you have to do is, in this construct, bar curly brace open close, within that, again bar y. Only then you will be able to get the second order. Then, the simplest method of representing this differentiation is y dash. You type here y dash, but in the output you will get y prime. What I mean to say is, suppose you type y dash outside maths concept, then you will have here y apostrophe s in the text mode. only in math mode you will have y dash appearing as y prime. That is why some people prefer to type this as y prime, and to represent second and third, fourth, etc. orders, you may use number of primes as may be necessary. Now, let us take the next case. We have dy by dx. I want to enclose this with round brackets. When I do it, I get the brackets all right, but the size is not appealing. The simplest method of getting it all right is by using left here and here right, and the brackets will be resized automatically. Size of the brackets will depend on the arguments within. Now, the peculiarity about this construct is, on this side, right hand side, you need not use round brackets, you can use even square brackets. LaTeX will not object to it. Again, you need not give anything, just say right dot, even that is acceptable by LaTeX. And you should not be tempted to remove this right altogether, because you get nothing in the output. If you do it, there will be a compilation error. Error will be missing right. You can see the error to be missing right. What I would suggest is, use here right. Then it will be alright. However, there are other methods also. For this, you have to use AMS Math package. If you use AMS Math package, you can say big this and then big this bracket. The size has increased, but not much. There are other variations also. Namely, you can have small big, capital big, small biggg, capital biggg. Depending upon what follows, the size can be increased as shown here. Now, depending upon your need, you may change it. One very important point that you have to notice here is, in the output, look at the vertical space. This seems to be too much. It is because in the editor, we have given here a space. Remove that space, then the vertical space gets reduced. Let us take another example. We have two line equations like this. We compile. We find in the output, it is not split into two lines, it exceeds the text area. Maybe you think that we have to give double slash here to break the line. Even then, there will be no change in the output. It is because this construct slash square bracket open, square bracket close is useful only for single line equations. Same thing is true for equation environment also. For multi-line equations, you have to use equin array. With the equin array environment, with the double slash, suppose you are going to refer to this equation, as equation 1 and this as equation 2, let us say. We give the labels like this. Compile. We find equations 2 and 3 appearing on two different lines. However, the alignment is not proper. Actual alignment shown in the output is the right. We would like to align them with respect to the equal to sign. In that case, put ampersand sign here on either side of equal to sign. If you do it, you will get it all right. One very important word of caution is, in this environment, in the last of the equations, do not use double slash. If you use double slash, you will have an empty line with the equation number alone, number 4. Remove that, only then this will be all right. Now, with the AMS package, there is another environment possible called align. The difference between equinary environment and align environment is, we need only one ampersand per line. You will have equations 4 and 5 with the help of align environment. The first set of equations 2 and 3 with the help of equinary environment. AMS math package has got so many other advantages. Therefore, hereafter, I will concentrate only on AMS math package. Now, if these two equations are not related to one another, then instead of align, you may use gather environment. In that case, you will not use ampersand here. You may use gather and then just type these two equations. With the align environment, you have to necessarily use the ampersand sign. You have these equations. Again, instead of this equation number appearing as 5, suppose this is a very special equation, you would like to name this equation after the person, or you would like to name this equation after some theorem, something like that. In that case, you may say tag, let us say I name this equation after Newton. Then, instead of number 5, you will have the word Newton appearing. If you say tag star, then the round brackets will go, only the word will remain. This is possible. Another thing is, suppose you don't want to have equation numbering at all, but you like to have only the alignment, then you can say star here, align star. When you say there is no equation number, then don't give labels. You will find in the second set, there is alignment without equation number. However, if you are interested in having equation number for only one of them or just a few of a set of equations, not for all, then use align environment. And then if you say you don't want to have equation number for the first one, say no number. Then for the second alone, there will be automatic equation number appearing as in this case. Now, let me take another case. Now, look at equation 6. Seems to be fine. Equation 5 is a plus b plus c whole square equal to so much. If a equal to 1, b equal to 2, c equal to 1 by 2, etc., then this equation seems to be fine. But sometimes we may encounter a problem like this. We prepare our research paper in a single column mode, but the journal wants it in a double column mode. In that case, what will happen is, I will switch over to double column mode. Then you will understand the problem that we face. Look at equation 5 and again equation 6. Equation 5 exceeds the column width. Therefore, equation 5 has to be broken. Let us break after a plus b plus c, a square plus b square plus c square. When you break it, remember to bring the operator also to the next line. What I mean to say is, break it here, take the operator also to the next line. In the first line, we don't want to have number, therefore type no number, and then line break, and then ampersand. Then you have equation 5 alright. Not exactly. If you look at the equal to sign and plus sign, they are aligned. It appears as if the first line is different from the second one. That should not be the case. We would like to insist that the second line is a continuation of the first line. Therefore, give a small space quad. Now, you can see the second line appears to be the continuation of the first line. Okay. Let us come to the next equation. We would like to break at this point. Let us say whole square and then we break here. Again, we use the same method, no number, etc. But you will find there are errors while compiling. The error is extra curly brace close. You may be wondering what it is. The reason is this. If you look at equation 6, we have used left open bracket, right open bracket. Both of the left and right must be in the single line. On the left hand side of equation 6, it is okay. But on the right hand side of equation 6, left open bracket is on one line, right close bracket is on the another line. Therefore, for every line, there must be a left and right. Corresponding to this left, you find right is here. We heat LaTeX like this. For left, you say right dot. And then for this point, we say left dot. Now there is no compilation error. But still, if you look at carefully, I enlarge this a bit. If you look at carefully, the opening round bracket is slightly larger than the closing round bracket. The reason is the size of the argument within. In the first line, you have this square, whereas such a construct is not available in the second line. Therefore, what you may do is, this is the culprit. You copy this. After left, you say V phantom. Phantom means invisible. Vertical invisible space. Within that, you give this construct, compile, you will find the bracket sizes match perfectly well. This is one method. Another method is to use manual sizing. When you use manual sizing for left here and right in the last line, we may use BIGG. And then in that case, right dot, left dot are not necessary. V phantom is also not necessary. You may use this construct in a special case when the size provided by BIGG dot is not sufficient for the argument within. In that case, only you may go for V phantom construct. Okay. Let me take another case. In physics or chemistry, you may come across what are known as thermodynamical equations of Maxwell. You have equations 7, 8, 9, 10 representing thermodynamical equations, Maxwell's equation. For partial derivatives, the command used is slash partial. Now, when we cross-reference them, there is a question mark. Doesn't matter. Compile them once again. You will get it. All right. Okay. Now, all these equations, 7, 8, 9, 10, represent Maxwell's equations. It will be better if they are given numbers like 7a, 7b, 7c, etc. Therefore, we use here sub-equations, environment, and then end sub-equations. You will find the equation numbering is changed. 7a, 7b, 7c, etc. And cross-referencing seems to be at fault. But LaTeX provides a warning. LaTeX warning is labels may have changed. Rerun to get the cross-references right. Compile it once again. You will get it all right. One more thing is, if you want to have equation numbering with respect to the sections, then you may use a command number within equation section. Then numbers will be given as per the sections. Since we have not used any section command here, section is taken to be 0. Let us say section introduction, let us say. Then equation numbers will be automatically section wise. Compile it once again to get the cross references right. That's all. Now, in the next video, I shall take some other special concepts and how to typeset them in LaTeX. Thank you for watching. Thank you very much.